number 432, A Miracle in Hell. Paradox. A statement that is seemingly contradictory or opposed to common sense, and yet it's perhaps true. Miracle. An extraordinary and welcome event that is not explicable by natural or the laws of science and is therefore attributed to the supernatural forces or a divine agency. For your grandpa and great-grandpa. This film we dedicate to Antoni Jaroszyński, concentration camp number 27483, whose death has not been explained yet, because there is a possibility that he was executed with fentanyl vaccine by Commando Pańszczyk on the June 23rd, 1942. That is on an eve of the 11th birthday anniversary of Antoni's son and my father, Kazimierz. He's yet another casualty of the German criminals. His cremated ashes were disposed of by being scattered in the Oświęcim area. In this tragic soil, they have remained up till now, along with the remains millions of his co-prisoners. In Labyrinth, memory cliches, Marian Kołodziej pay homage exactly to those unnamed, non-buried casualties who had been given no graves. By each and every pencil stroke made by the artist with his paralyzed hand, this monumental artwork is a tribute to those victims. Infamy and condemnation to those who are trying to own, misrepresent, distort and shift responsibility of the cruelest crime of the World War II that KL Auschwitz was. Karol and Ksawery Jaroszyńscy. What if this history never existed? What if he had died on the train catastrophe? What if this person hadn't survived because he was not allowed to? What if he had been executed, starved, or tortured physically and mentally to death? What if he hadn't offered to his fellow prisoner a few spoonfuls of Zulaga, concentration camp soup? What if he hadn't seen normal life duties outside the camp? What if he hadn't seen the tears in the eyes of the assessmen? What if the paradoxes, or more correctly, miracles that caused that we are here? What if that human cramp, who felt the two totalitarian systems on his back, had simply failed to handle and broken into pieces? How many of those what ifs will it take to notice the signs? And signs need to be deciphered. June 22nd, 1939, Hitler in Obersalzberg. I prepared in the East yet my Totenkopf troops, ordering them to kill mercilessly and ruthlessly, without compassion, men, women and children of Polish origin and Polish language. This is the only way to accomplish and spread our space to live that we need. Poland would be depopulated and repopulated by Germans. This idea was specified and presented on March 15, 1940, to all concentration camp commanders in previously occupied Poland by the SS commander Heinrich Himmler. All professionals must be used in our war machine facilities. And then Poles shall disappear from the face of Earth. Therefore, it is necessary that the great German nation seeks their main and principal task, that is the destruction and extermination of all Poles. The story we want to tell in our film seems so intriguing and unreal that a person with common sense, who knows the realities of those times, wouldn't have believed they actually happened. Then I saw a great crowd that no one could count, from every nation and all tribes, peoples and languages. Apocalypse by Sun Chan. Thoughts of an intelligent being, Mr. Cogito. You survive not to live. You have little much time left. You have to give a testimony. Came from under the pen of Zbigniew Herbert, the Duke of the Unbroken and Steadfast Poets, who directed himself through the potency and the greatness of taste. These words, in conjunction with the strength of the youth experience of juvenescent human being, gave that fruit in shape of the labyrinths, memory cliches, that means photo frames, of the number 432. Let these words become a message and provide the warning for the generations to come. The scale of his emotions, his will to survive, his personal pride of the human being led us to be here in this place, in the casemates of his youth. Here paradoxes emerged on the verge of miracles, or maybe miracles they were. The choice, judgment, and valuations are yours to make. What could have been more paradoxical than the fact that the death sentence verdict issued to the number 432 by the Third Reich Court actually saves his life? This is just an absurd. The German death machine is so successful in putting to death and annihilating millions of people in thousands of ways, stumbles over in this case and saves number 432. And all of that caused by a few spoonfuls of Zulaga, concentration camp soup, shared a few years earlier by Marian Kołodziej with his fellow prisoner Tadeusz Szymański. This man survived and became a camp writer whose task was to fill up the lists of those were being sent to death penalty in accordance with the prisoners' files brought him by SS man from the camp establishment. File number 432 lands at the bottom of that stack, and it remains there until the evacuation order arrives. Then the file appeared at the top of that stack of prisoners chosen for deportation. God gives a man a talent and the God sparks and observes what the human being does with these gifts. And as Witold Pilecki had once said, that concentration camp was a test and trial of the characters, which was not passed by everyone equally. Some rolled down to the moral swamp, collaborated, helped knackers and torturers, became informers called capo, and malicious scoundrels. But some polished their characters like crystals. They were hit and sculpted with the sharp devices. Blows were painful and deeply carved their bodies, but their souls were places to plow. Those who survived these circumstances were of the prime and the best purity. Marian Kowoji wholly covers that term. Because of the next paradox or miracle, you're observing something what could have never happened. A lot of words were spoken about cliches, but one sentence said by Joseph Tischner, a Catholic priest, best exemplifies the essence of their testimony and evidence. Right here is Rio Concentration Lager Auschwitz. Yes, right here, in Harmenge. Not in Oświęcim. We are experiencing the concentration camp reality, wandering through labyrinths of the human dilemmas, moments of doubt, facing the overwhelming evil and cruelty. Hope, care, and cheer caused by a simple human and hearty reaction. In this, these circumstances rose up to the Shakespearean phrase, to be or not to be. The act of utmost courage of Father Maximilian Maria Kolbe, camp number 16,670, whose starvation death saved the life of the number 432 and returned Marian Kołodziej to the living. But also the words from the Bible that grain which decays would give a great harvest were prophetic. And so a miracle of a rebirth in that Anus Mundi, which became a remorse to the entire civilized world. Mama, at the end of May, I was transported to the camp of Oświęcim. I'm fine, my dear mama. Don't be afraid of my condition and health, because the loving God is everywhere. And with enormous love, He thinks about everyone and everything. It would be better not to write before my next message arrives, as I don't know how long I'd stay here. With the most sincere greetings and loving kisses, Kolbe Raymond. Be praised, my Lord, by all those who forgive because of your love, and endure all diseases and persecutions for your love. Happy are those who do not lose their peace in adversity, for by you, the Highest, they will be crowned. Angel of God, a guardian of mine, stay by me all the time. Brought by the first transport on June 14, 1940 to the camp, not being a functional worker, on the contrary, he performed the hardest and the most exhausting jobs, like transport gassed bodies to the crematory furnaces. Brushing against death, right here, in the undercamp Harmense, during chilling November day, he was standing in the freezing water and mowing the cane in the pond. Brought half dead from the fever and exhaustion by his fellow prisoners to the camp hospital, he regenerated his strength only to continue this slavery life. But strength of youth, faith, and enormous will to survive gave him the last cut of character and made him clear beyond the human imagination. A paradox or a miracle? Stefan Jarach, actor about Karl Auschwitz. People were surprised when I, upon my return from Oświęcim, I did not want to talk about it. Although everything was real there, after a while the mind stopped accepting it realistically. Because how do you explain the possibility of standing naked in the freezing cold for many hours? How to explain the possibility of sleeping on a concrete floor covered in water? Everything that a person would die from in Oświęcim you sometimes endured for years until death had mercy on you. I've seen a lot of without believing that I can see, an experience without believing that I'm alive. And I must admit that my comrades tried to spare me. I rarely carried corpses. I was rarely mistreated, even rarely beaten, and I was hit in the head with the rifle only once. On the other hand, I peeled potatoes relatively often in the kitchen, often in the terrible silence of hundreds of people. I would tell them the poems from the heart to the hearts, at the bottom of the stinking pit of the human misery. And I experienced a beautiful, sublime moment together with Schiller. It so happened that me and him dragged some wheelbarrow with utter physical exhaustion, and we both fell down like powerless old men. And we started to lift ourselves, helping each other, and our hands clenched, and our eyes filled with tears. And we swore to each other that we would never fight again. And in future Poland promised each other to work our hand to bone towards a better tomorrow of the theater. Is it not also a paradox that the paralysis resulting from a brain stroke that would immobilize the right side, including the arm of Marian Kołodziej, formerly an extraordinary theater set designer who lived on for and thanks to his art, would make him create something above 700 square meters of engravings, initially drawn with pencils tied to the fingers. A dash after dash. And each dash is to symbolize a single human being annihilated by the cruelest death machine that Karl Auschwitz was. A paradox or a miracle? Was it a miracle, or perhaps a paradox, to see the tears in the eyes of the assessment? Sitting in a cell, Marian Kołodziej is awaiting for the judgment of the Third Reich Court. An assessment asks him to paint a portrait of his son, who is on a vacation and visiting his father. He's a Luftwaffe pilot. Kołodziej sketches him life and promises to finish it with the following Sunday. When he returns his job, tears appear in the eyes of an assessment. Needless to say, the assessment were trained to be free from the human reactions. For them, killing another human being was a sport or entertainment. Yet, those father's tears were sincere and unstoppable, as in a voice that was moved and choked by crying, he said, "This is my last reminder of my son, for he was recently shot down in the Battle of the English Channel." Kołodziej saw it with his own eyes and found out that SS men are also human beings with their weaknesses and problems, as well as their feelings. to have weight of your own. The lack of our participation, determination, but also ordinary human honesty and sensitivity may cause the ideas that guided the creators of this concentration camp to return and deprive us and future generations of what the prisoner number 432 and later Marian Kowodzi were fighting for with such dedication, pride, and weight of the good and evil, like that weight of an everyday bread, so meticulously and with so absurdly precise honesty weighed in these paranoidal circumstances. Look at yourself and deep inside of yourself. Who am I? What am I doing? How do I treat other people? Let's make a sort of an examination of conscience from many years that passed and put yourself right next to Marian Kowodzi, who returned to the traumatic moments in the camp. Sarcastic, hurrah, hurrah, ich bin wieder da. Hooray, hooray, I'm back here again. Let it make you aware of the trauma suffered by a man caught in an attempt to escape from the cesspool of humanity. Confession. May it will become the catharsis of our souls and at the same time the beginning of something very, very important and great. Because ours, without looking at others, soft totalitarianism hardened and solidified, and no longer knocks on our door, but puts its shaggy leg into the door, slightly opened. After World War II, when one form of totalitarianism collapsed and was judged, the other one acted at its best, absorbing and twisting characters by the same methods. Communism introduced the reign of terror with the help of traitors. Some wanted to make big money on staying in the camp. Marian Kołodziej despised them, saying in one of the interviews that many people whitewashed their actions in the camp, and in fact they acted as the helpers of the torturers and ordinary couple. He did not want to identify with them, which was probably the reason behind the half-century-long silence. Separation from those procrastinators and scoundrels who, by falsifying history, usurped and continue to usurp the right to decide on the matter of whose pain was greater and whose pain was lesser. Those who need to be lifted up on the pedestals and those who... Message from Marian Kołodziej to visitors. Before you immerse yourself in everyday life, stop. Listen again to what I, number 432, am telling you. I would like to thank you for the common experience of Auschwitz. Your presence here, your individual experience of my cliché of memory, crossing my labyrinth, is a tribute to my comrades who were burned to ashes, have passed away, and yet they stayed with me forever. My drawings, the ones you saw, were tattooed on my skin as well as the number 432. These are my carved wounds, whipped in public with unimaginable cruelty. Bleeding profusely, I crawled through the streets of the camps, carrying my concrete crosses to my Golgotha. This is my cry of pain and rebellion. My nakedness, my shame, my futile sermons of painfully drawn lines. Such rock carvings, cave carvings, for the future, a testimony of animality, but also attempts to save one's humanity in the 20th century. The dialogue of the human being with suffering goes deeper than the dialogue of the man with death, André Malraux. Holocaust, the destruction of millions, the enormity of the tragedy, selection for gas, everyday death in the pigsty of the camp, in constant hunger, filth and degeneration, driven to work with curses, in despair, hopelessness, whole 5 years. Now as then, I scratch on my wall my death row questions. Help me. What you wanted to see is only now, not only in Oświęcim. In silence and reflection, please think about what you've seen and let yourself think what it really means for you getting to know a human. The artist's disagreement with obliterating the responsibility of the Germans, as well as appropriating the exclusivity of one nation to mourn its victims, bypassing others, resulted in the fact that the cliché were not found on the premises of the KL Auschwitz Museum itself, but here, in Harmenge, like that pile of crosses thrown out from the camp's gravel yard. And this is the last miracle that we have cliché here under the loving care of the conventual Franciscans right next to the St. Maximilian Center, who was the one saying, "Evil is not a creative force, but only good is." When creating cliché, Marian Kołodziej, number 432, did not want to provoke aggression in us, but to overwhelm us with the power of expression and make us think of who we are, where are we going, and how much strength will we find in ourselves to oppose evil. Are you able to reject violence, dehumanization, but also a silent consent to the spreading evil, and do not look at it passively from the side when you should scream to move the conscience of others? Be faithful.